गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू पाइथन क्लास. टुडे हियर आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट वन मोर ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ पाइथन, वन मोर मॉड्यूल ऑफ अ पाइथन, दैट इज नंपाई. ओके, एक्चुअली व्हाट इज दिस नंपाई इज, इट इज अ लाइब्रेरी फाइल. ओके, लाइक इन सी प्रोग्रामिंग यू हैव अ stdio.h एंड इन सी प्लस प्लस यू हैव अ iostream.h. From that header files and that from that streams, you will get a number of functions, and that function, using that function you can write a program. Similarly, in Python, here we have a one object called NumPy, and this library file helps the programmer to perform a different operations on arrays, and this NumPy. Library file mainly focused on multi-dimensional array, n-dimensional array. So now we'll see the what is a NumPy and what the features you are getting from a NumPy. Okay, so as already said, NumPy is a Python package. See, like in Java you have package, and that package is a packages are collection of classes, and the classes are a collection of different methods. Similarly, in Python, NumPy is also a package that helps the programmer to perform different applications, different functions on arrays. And here, NumPy stands for Numerical Python, means it's mainly focused on numerical means operations. Like a numerical application means it is mainly deal with the mathematical applications, algebraic functions, like that. So here this library file is mainly designed to perform different operations on numerical data, and it is a open source. Open source means anyone can download this package from a internet. It is open source. Okay, and this package is available from a Python library. Okay, and it is main, as I already said, NumPy is mainly deals with multi-dimensional array and matrix. See, matrix, if you want to create a matrix in C, C++, what we use the two-dimensional array. Similarly, in Python, using this NumPy package, we can create a multi-dimensional array, and you can perform different operations on multi-dimensional array. Okay, so you can underline that point. It is mainly deals with matrix data structures. Okay, and as we already said, this package contains different library functions that can perform number of mathematical operations on arrays, such as trigonometric, statistical, and algebraic. Okay, so this contains different types of functions, and that functions can be performed on arrays. So you try to remember one point here: NumPy is mainly focused on arrays. Okay, so using this we can create n-dimensional array, we can perform different operations on n-dimensional array. Okay, and this is a extension of numeric array. Now we have more features of NumPy here. It is also used to generate random numbers. See, if you give the starting number and ending number, it will create the different series. Okay, so that is why it is also called as a number generators. And this NumPy library file contains different functions which are working with different algebra and Fourier transform and matrices. Okay, and this NumPy is also contains array object. Okay, object means it is a collection of different methods and data. Similarly, NumPy library file contains array object, which is very faster compared to the traditional list in a Python. So actually, before the arrays, we used a list in a Python. So when you compare this array object with the Python list, array object perform operations very fastly and quickly. Okay, and this array object in NumPy. As I already said, in NumPy, array is a one object. And that object is called as a ND array, n dimensional array. Okay, and it provides that this array object provides a lot of supporting functions that that makes works very easy when you are working with an array. Okay, so what here, array is an object of which library file? NumPy. And what it contains? A number of functions which you can perform an array. Okay, and this NumPy contains different objects, and that objects are designed by using C, C++. So this NumPy is also integrated with C, C++. Okay, and this NumPy is also contains different functions, and it which works efficiently with multi-dimensional array. Now we'll discuss how NumPy array works. Actually, what is a NumPy array? Okay, see here I have given in a PPT. NumPy array is a powerful n-dimensional array object. You underline that point. NumPy array actually which contains an object which is very powerful n-dimensional array. N-dimensional means it is more than 2, okay, which is in the form of rows and column. See, in C, C++ we already worked with arrays, like there you have a 1-dimensional array, 2-dimensional array, 3-dimensional array. But compared to that programming languages, creating n-dimensional array in Python is very easy. And you can perform different operations on that n-dimensional array by using a NumPy library file. Okay. Now, here I'll give you the syntax, how to create a NumPy array. See, in order to create a, if you want to create a NumPy array object in Python, here you can see import statement. Okay. So, import NumPy as np. See, directly you can give import np, or you can give import NumPy as np. See, this np is a short form of NumPy. Okay, now here I am creating an array. Array name is arr. What is the name of the array? Arr. And equals to np dot array. Here np is a Python library file, and array is what here? Array is a function, okay, or you can say that it is an object. Okay, the array object, actually it is np is a library file and array is an object, and using that object we are created one array, and elements of that array is 1 2 3 4 5. Now we are printing that. You see the output 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here, if you want to create an array using the NumPy class, you can see simply just you need to import NumPy. See, in Java also you have a NumPy. There also we are importing a package. When you are importing a package, whatever classes are available in that package, that all invoked into your program. Similarly, if you want to use any object of the NumPy class, NumPy library file, first you need to import that. So using the import keyword, we are importing all the objects, all the functions available in NumPy into our program. Now, instead of writing a NumPy every time, I am giving a alias. Okay, import NumPy as np. So wherever you want to write a NumPy, there you can write a np. Now in the second line, I have created an array. Array name is arr equals to np. Here what is mean by np? It is a NumPy because it is an alias. NumPy dot array is an object here. Using that object, I am creating an array. And what are the elements of the array here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So I have created one object of NumPy class. So if you have created an object of a NumPy class, what if you have imported NumPy class, whatever functions are available in that NumPy class, you can import all that functions into your program. Okay, so this is about creating NumPy ND array object, n dimensional array. Okay, and here in this definition you can see NumPy is used to work with arrays. Okay, as already said, NumPy is mainly focused on arrays, means it contains different functionalities which can work on the arrays. Okay, now here using a NumPy you can find out different dimensions of the array. Okay, different dimensions means how many subscripts that array have. This already I have explained, means you have learned this in C, C++ and Java. 1D array, 2Ds, 3Ds. Okay, it is nothing but the number of a subscript. So, using a NumPy array, you can create arrays with the different dimensions. So, here I have given different dimensions of a Python. Okay, different dimensions of an array. Okay, a dimension in an array is one level. Okay, it is a depth. Clear definition. Now, first one is zero dimension. Means, see, if you have only one element, okay, if it is more than one element, that is a one dimension array. But if you have only single element, that is a zero dimension array. Okay, so here you can see, I have given one example. Import NumPy. I am importing NumPy as np. Means wherever you want to use a NumPy, there you can write np. And array is an object. In the object, what I have given 42. It is a single element. So there is no particular row. So if it is at least, if you have more than one element, you can consider it as a single dimension array. So you are only single element. So such array is called as a zero dimension array. Okay. Now come to the one dimensional array. So here it is small spelling mistake. It is a one dimensional array. Okay, one dimensional array means it is more than one element. Okay, so you can see that an array that has zero dimensional array as its element. Okay, you can underline that point. An array that has zero dimension arrays as its element. So it is nothing but, or you can say that one dimensional array is a collection of zero dimensional. Okay, such array is called as a one dimensional array, or it is also called as a unidimensional array. Okay, so what is a one dimensional array? One dimensional array is a collection of zero dimensional array. Okay, you can see that in example. So in a zero dimensional array, what I have given? I have given only single element, whereas in one dimensional array I have given more number of elements. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, you can see the example program. As I'm importing NumPy as np, see, import NumPy as np is optional. Directly you can give import NumPy. Now what is the name of the array? Arr equals to np is a alias to NumPy, and I am creating an object 1, 2, 3 array object. So how many elements we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here each element is called as a zero dimensional. So that is why one dimensional array is called as a collection of zero dimensional array. Now I am printing that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now come to the two dimensional array. Similarly, in one dimensional array, what I have given is a collection of zero dimensional array. So in two dimensional array, we can say that two dimensional array is a collection of one dimensional array. Okay, two dimensional array is a collection of one dimensional array. Okay, so here you can see the example. I had created two dimensional array with 6 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3 is a first row, and 4, 5, 6 is a second row. Okay, so here you can see in the example program, import NumPy. I am importing NumPy and I am creating an object array 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and print array. This already I've explained in the previous classes. Once you go through that, now come to the three-dimensional array. See, an array that has two-dimensional array matrices as its elements is called as a 3D array. Okay, for one-dimensional array, it is a collection of zero dimension. For two-dimensional array, it is a collection of one-dimensional array. And for a three-dimensional array, it is a collection of two-dimensional array matrices. Okay, so this is a advanced features available in Python. Okay, now you can see here I have created a three-dimensional array. I had imported NumPy. Next, I have created one array, array object, ARRAY. It's the object. ARR is the name of the array. So you can see how many elements are there. One dimension, you can see there are first, this is a two dimensional array, first two dimensional. Okay, so 1 2 3 4 5 6 is a two dimensional array. Again 1 2 3 4 5 6 is a two dimensional array. So as already said, three dimensional array is a collection of two dimensional array. Okay, you can see that total how many rows will be printed on the screen? Four rows. First row is 1, 2, 3. Second row is 4, 5, 6. Third row is 1, 2, 3. And the fourth row is 4, 5, 6. Okay, so three-dimensional array is a collection of two-dimensional. Okay, in this example, three-dimensional array contains two two-dimensional arrays. Okay, now what operations you can perform on operations, means what operations you are getting from NumPy which you can perform on arrays. Okay, the first one is a n dimension. Using this n dimension function, you can find out how many dimensions are there in the array, means whether it is a one dimensional array, it is a two dimensional array, or it is a three-dimensional array. Okay, so here I have given np array 1 2 3 4 5 6. Here how many dimensions you have, that you will get. It is a two-dimensional array. Okay, now the second one is item size. So here what is the item size is, here we have a three elements 1 2 3. Okay, so here each element is a type of integer. Now, using this item size, I will find out what is the size of each element. Okay, what is the size of each element? So here in Python, for each and every element size, integer element size is here 4 bytes. Okay, 1, 2, 3 means first element size is 4 bytes, second element size is 4 bytes, third element size is 4 bytes. So using the item size function, you can find out, you can calculate size of each element in the array. Array is a collection of different elements. You can find out, and it is here in a Python, every array should have a homogeneous element. So here are all the elements of integer. So you can find out size of each integer. So in order to print size of each integer, each element of the array, here I have given, you see, print a dot item size. Here what is the a name of the array? In that array, I want to find out size of each element. Okay, so whatever elements are there in the array, I want to find out each and every element size of that array a. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 3 are of integers, and size of each element is a 4 bytes. That I have given as a 4 bytes. Okay. Now come to the D type. Here D type is nothing but the data type. Like in a C, C++, you have a data types. Similarly, in Python also we have a data types for element. We won't mention, but internally for each and every value there is a data type. So whatever elements you have given, you want to find out the data type of that elements. Here we'll use a D type function. Okay, once you go through the definition, we can find out the data type of the element, that are stored in an array. Okay. So D type is nothing but the data type. Using this function, what we are doing? Just we are finding size data type of the array. So whatever elements you have given, what is the data type of that element? In this example, whatever elements I have given, all those elements are of integers. So here it will display size of data type of each element, and the size also it will display. See, 1, 2, 3, all are integers, so it is displaying int. So you can see print is a output function in Python. Next, in the printf function, I have given a dot d type. What is the a here? A is the name of the array. D type is a function, means that function is performing on that array. Okay, so what is the function actually? It is used to find the data type. So from where it is finding, finding in the array, which is called as a. Okay, so that is why it is displaying a integer D type. First, once you go through the syntax in the print itself, I have given in the output statement itself, I have given the syntax, means you need to give the array dot D type. Okay, here array is a, D type is a function. Now come to the fourth one, size and shape. Okay, here using this size and shape function, we can again here one spelling mistake is there, it is a weekend. We can find the size and the shape of the array using a size and shape function. See, size and shape means here how many elements are there? One row, six column. Next, total six actually it is. Size is a six element and shape is a one row, six columns. That is a size and shape function. Using a size and shape function, we can find out the size. We can find out the size, means total how many elements are there in the array, and shape we can find out. It's like a dimension. On x-axis how many elements we have, and y-axis how much you have. That you can find out by using a size and shape. Okay. So using a D type, what we are finding? Using a D type, we are finding the data type of an element. Using a size and shape, what we are finding? Using a size function, we are finding how many elements are there in the array. So there are total six elements are there in the array. So it is output is a six, and shape it is a one row, six columns. Okay, so that is a shape function. Now here we have a more functions, reshape. See, what is a reshape function? Reshape means, see, actually it is called as a, it is like a transform. Rows are converted into the converted into the columns, and the columns are converted into the rows. So reshape is when you want to change the number of rows and columns, which gives a new view to an object. See, in the picture I have given two rows, three columns. Okay, two rows, three columns. So that is changed into three rows, two columns. That is the reshaping. Okay, see, in the example, once you see, I have created NumPy, and array, how many elements we have in the array? Six element, two rows, three columns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, first row 8, 9, 10, second row 11, 12, 13. Now, I am printing that first. Next, again, I am reshaping that, A equals to A dot reshape. And when you are reshaping, when you are changing the array, when you are giving a new look to the array, how you want, how your target shape, that also you should give. So what target I have given? Three rows, two columns. Okay, so according that I have given the output. Okay, so I have given a new shape, three rows, two columns. I am changed the total object shape. Okay, but how you want that information also you should give. Now come to the slicing. Actually, what is mean by slicing? Slicing is a part of the array. Okay, example, if you have a bread that is a complete object, no, your slicing means you are cutting into pieces. Similarly, here slicing is nothing but we have an array. Instead of the complete array, instead of displaying complete array at a time, I want to display part of the array only. Part only I want to display. I don't want to display the complete array. Part of the means few elements only I want. So when you want to display only few elements, you can go with the slicing. Okay. So you can see the definition. Slicing is basically extracting particular set of elements. Means, example, if you have 20 elements, out of the 20 elements, I want only 10 elements. So that picking that 10 elements is called as a slicing process. So here you can see the code, import numpy as np alias, and I have created an object 1 2 3 4, means array object I have created 1 2 3 4. Next to 3 4 5 6, total in many elements I have given 8 elements, but I want to print only the first row second column. See, in the first row second column, what you have? Number 3 you have. See, first row means 1 2 3 4 is the first row, and I think you all know array elements start from a 0. Now 2 I have given. In the 0 position you have a 1, in the 1 position you have a 2, in the second position you have a 3. So in from the first row I want to display the second one, so that element will be a 3. Okay. So these are the few functions of NumPy. Okay, it contains these more functions are there that will continue in the next class. Okay, so for here just I have explained 6 functions, more 10 functions you have, that I will explain in the next class. Okay, so here what is a NumPy? NumPy is a library file which contains different functions that can be performed on arrays. And this NumPy is the main advantage of this NumPy library file is it performs different operations on n-dimensional array. Okay, using a NumPy it is easy to create n-dimensional array, and it is easy to perform different operations on n-dimensional array. So how to create a NumPy array object? See, I have created arr equals to np dot array. Your array object of which class? NP. Sorry, which library? NP. Okay. And that object name is arr. So like this, you can perform different operations on n-dimensional array using a NumPy class. This is about introduction of NumPy and a few functions which are supported by NumPy library file, and which can be performed on array. Okay, and more functions are there that will continue in the next class.